And then in 2015, a lot of frameworks started to form, and then in 2016, we started having conferences about it. And traditional architecture sort of puts you in something like this, just like this, client sitting in, coming into some, front end tier. You know, your web server is kind of horizontally scaling out, and then you have your data tier kind of at the back end. And that's not really how it works anymore. And like now you can just draw lines like all over the place here where your client's talking to your auth service and gateway, and there's functions underneath that the API gateway talks to, and that may talk to your data tier. Your client may talk to the data tier, on its own as well, going through that side, and your web assets are delivered to like Amazon S3 or whatever, like your JavaScript and your HTML and whatever. So Patrick Dubois, he's the guy who coined the word DevOps back in 2009. He started DevOps Days, and we really see him as the people call him the godfather of DevOps, but he hates that title and to be kind of treated that way. But we all love Patrick. But he was doing an online survey about like, why are people gravitating towards serverless? What makes that architecture pattern really interesting for folks? And some people were like, yeah, I don't have to worry about servers anymore. I'm able to pay per request. I have instant capacity. But everybody who started rallying around this idea is functions as deployable units. And I think that's a really good thing to keep in the definition, because I think that's the thing that the community it has focused on the serverless. So I think that we can adequately say that serverless is about functions as a service. This is Lambda, Amazon Lambda, Google Cloud Functions, Azure Functions, and some people could say, like, is this containers? Like, are containers considered serverless? Kind of, but serverless hinges on containers that spin up, run, execute your code, and then disappear. But I wouldn't say, like, just raw containers, especially containers you manage or you run in-house, like, even if you're using like some of the orchestration frameworks, though some are starting to like work on the idea of handling this kind of stuff. But I think that if we were back in 2004, we would have probably named serverless containers on demand. That's another one of the jokes that we'll be seeing today. I don't know. I like the on demand the theme that we had going back then. But now now we're thinking of serverless as not managing services. We are also very service-full. And I like it because we're now thinking of an opinionated framework for how we do computing. And just like the cloud was the virtualization, which I'll talk about in a moment.